Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good afternoon, everybody. Welcome to guest lecture of the Agriculture and Biosystem Engineering. This guest lecture with the title of Importance of Rheology in Chocolate Industry. First of all, let me introduce myself. My name is Ricky Stomo, students from Agriculture and Biosystem Engineering, Universitas Gajah Mada. Will be the today's event master ceremony. This event is part of a weekly series of workshops that are held twice a week to be a part of implementation of independent campus competition program with agricultural and biosystem engineering partners. Therefore, we will get to know more about agricultural technology and gaining various benefits. So don't miss out on participating in every series of this workshop. Baiklah, sebelum memulai rangkaian acara kuliah tamu ini, izinkan saya untuk menyampaikan beberapa tata tertib yang harus dipatuhi sepanjang kegiatan ini berlangsung. Yang pertama, peserta diwajibkan hadir 10 menit sebelum acara dimulai, yakni pukul 13.50 waktu Indonesia Barat. Peserta wajib menggunakan format penamaan instansi underscore nama lengkap. Untuk mengubah format penamaan tersebut, Anda dapat menekan tombol di pojok kanan atas pada participant list, kemudian tekan more, lalu tekan rename, dan isikan sesuai format yang telah disepakati, yakni instansi underscore nama lengkap. Yang ketiga, peserta diharapkan menggunakan virtual background yang telah disediakan oleh panitia selama sesi workshop berlangsung. Virtual background tersebut dapat diakses melalui link yang akan disampaikan pada kolom chat. Keempat, peserta diharapkan untuk mengaktifkan video selama sesi workshop berlangsung. Kelima, peserta wajib menonaktifkan suara selama sesi workshop berlangsung, kecuali memperoleh izin dari moderator atau panitia PKKM. Keenam, peserta yang mengalami kendala selama kegiatan berlangsung dapat menghubungi panitia melalui private chat. Ketujuh, peserta diharapkan berpakaian dan berperilaku sopan selama sesi workshop berlangsung. Kedelapan, peserta dapat menyampaikan pertanyaan melalui kolom chat atau secara langsung melalui mikrofon setelah dipersilakan oleh moderator. Kesembilan, dimohon bagi para peserta untuk dapat mengisi presensi kehadiran melalui tautan yang akan disediakan ketika sesi berlangsung. Kemudian yang terakhir, informasi seri selanjutnya workshop PKKM dapat dilihat pada akun Instagram kami, yakni @tpb.ugm, serta akun Facebook atau Twitter @tpbugm. Diharapkan seluruh peserta mematuhi tata tertib yang ada supaya kuliah tamu dapat berjalan dengan lancar. In this afternoon, we will discuss together with Prof. Dr. Omed Said Stoker from Department of Food Engineering, Yıldız Technical University, Turkey, with the topic Rheology in Chocolate Industry. We will start this discussion with our moderator. He is Mr. Dr. Arifin Dwi Saputro, STP, MSc, that will be introduced from this CV. Mr. Dr. Arifin Dwi Saputro is the bachelor in agricultural engineering, Universitas Gajah Mada, master in food science and technology, Universitas Gajah Mada, doctoral program in biological science, University of Jain, expertise cocoa and chocolate production. Research. Studi faktor intrinsik, ekstrinsik, dan ekstrinsik determinan pada atribut mutu pangan fungsional berbasis kakao tipe single origin coklat. Kemudian pengembangan teknik instansi minuman berbasis cocoa powder dengan menggunakan continuous and batch type steam jet agglomerator. Pengembangan teknologi evaporasi dan kristalisasi yang higienis dan hemat energi untuk pengolahan gula semut berbasis nira palma skala industri kecil sebagai upaya peningkatan kuantitas dan kualitas produk. Pengembangan teknik produksi coklat tahan panas atau heat resistant coklat dengan cara pembentukan sugar network yang diproduksi menggunakan small-scale processing system. Pengembangan teknik instansi minuman berbasis cocoa powder dengan menggunakan jet steam agglomerator sebagai upaya hilirisasi produk turunan kakao. Baik, without delaying time, let's start discussion with Mr. Arifin Dwi Saputro. Mr. Arifin Dwi Saputro, the time is yours.
Okay, thank you, Mas Riki Sutomo. Can you hear my voice?
Yes, so clear, Mister.
Okay, thank you. Good afternoon, everyone. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. How are you today? I hope you are all safe, healthy, and yeah, also happy. Yeah. First of all, welcome to the 5th International General Lecture or talk show that is organized as part of PKKM program, or we call it in Indonesian as a program kompetisi Kampus Merdeka, which is implemented in or at Department of Agricultural and Biosystems Engineering. At this moment, again, I am going to serve as a moderator with the very interesting topic entitled Importance of Rheology in Chocolate Industry. As you may know, that flow properties of chocolates are very important, not only with regard to the mouthfeel and consumer acceptance, but also for the handling properties during a chocolate application. Rheologically, for you, for a student who study about rheology, molten chocolate exhibits a non-Newtonian flow behavior, which is usually described by a yield stress and plastic viscosity. What are they? In this chance, Prof. Omer Said Toker will be elaborating this topic. So, yeah, please, for you who really interested in this topic, yeah, you can find some food and also drink so that you can really enjoy and you can finish this lecture until the end. Okay, before we begin, I would like to introduce Associate Professor Omer Said Toker, which is actually also, yeah, has been introduced by Riki Sutomo. Prof. Toker is currently affiliated with Department of Food Engineering, Yildiz Technical University, Turkey. He has years of experience in cocoa and chocolate processing. We can see from his publication, if you check his Google Scholar or Scopus account, you can see that he has a lot of publication with not only hundreds, but also thousands of citations. We can see that he has around, H index, at least 30. You can see from this that, he really masters in this area. At the beginning, Professor Toker will deliver his lecture, and afterwards, we will go with the question and answer session. Before we start, I would like to remind you, all the participants, please to put your microphone on mute and fill the attendance form. So the committee will send you a link on the chat room. Please fill in, the attendance form. And if you have any question, you can write it down in the chat box. You can write it down in Indonesian language or also in English. Aside from this, you can also, if you want, you can just click a raise hand sign so that you can directly ask your question to the Prof. Toker. Okay, without further delay, I would like to give the screen and time to Prof. Toker, please.
Thanks, Professor Saputra. Firstly, hello, dear professors, students, and participants from industry. I am very pleased and honored to be invited this excellent organization, and I am also very honored to be with you today. As Professor Saputra mentioned, today I want to talk about the basic rheology and rheology importance of the rheology in chocolate industry. Before passing my presentation, I want to learn, is there anyone experienced with rheology until now? Can you raise your hands? Professor Saputro, is it free to ask questions in presentation?
Yes. Sure.
Because I like ask questions during presentation.
Yeah, for sure. Maybe also, yeah, I can help you, yeah, to find the student who can answer your question. Maybe Ricky Sutomo, you can answer. Or my student who, yeah, learn about rheology. I will find them for you. Hilal.
As I see, generally, most of them did not have any experience, yeah?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. Start. We can start our presentation. Can you see presentation?
Yeah.
Okay. Is there any problem with voice?
Everything is perfect.
Okay. Thank you. Firstly, rheology, rheo means to flow, logos means science, and ology the study. The description of the rheology is the science that concerns the deformation of the deformation of solid and fluid of the liquids. In terms of food, rheology is the study of the deformation and flow of the raw materials, the intermediate products, and the final products of the food industry. As we see in the definition of the rheology, there are two parts. One of them is deformation of solid, one of them is fluid of the liquids. Therefore, is there any flow? It means that there is a deformation also. Therefore, we are saying that the rheology is interested with the deformation of solid and flow of the liquid materials. Within the food industry, it is very important to understand how your food will behave. Will it be deformed or will it flow through a pipe? Will it stay on your product? Will it thicken up or no? If you want your product to be made efficiently and stay good during storage and transport, it is useful to know more about these physical properties of your food or your material in general. For example, ketchup doesn't flow out of the bottle by itself. Instead, it will only flow once you have shaken or pressed the bottle or tube. By measuring the rheology of materials that show this behavior, you will see some similarities. Water flows out of a cup really easily and pretty fast. Honey, on the other hand, flows very differently. It flows more slowly and in a t- thicker syrupy consistency. Even try to mix corn starch with a little bit of water. If so, you might have noticed that it will flow out of your bowl when you tilt it. However, once you start stirring vigorously with a spoon, it will become pretty tall. It thickens up, but once you stop stirring and gently move the spoon, it becomes a lot easier again. If you look YouTube, there are very good videos about this, about the thickening of the starch. Rheology looks into all of those phenomena and will help explain what happens, why it happens, and how it can be changed or not changed. Where we are benefited from rheology, for example, formulation, composition, determination of formulation, composition of food materials, additives and stabilizers. We use viscosity and flow behavior of formulation, production process, flow behavior, viscosity and elasticity of the materials are also important. Storage, during storage, there can be a sedimentation and stability problems, crystallization problems. We can also observe this with rheological measurements. We encounter rheology in our daily life. For example, we are spreading chocolate on the bread. We are eating yogurt with pieces of fruit suspended in it, squeezing toothpaste tubes every day, kneading bread dough, rubbing skin lotion on our body, chewing gum. When we look our daily life, we encounter rheology in every parts of our life. We can summarize it. If there is a force we applied on a material, there is rheology. For example, we can evaluate the freshness of bread in the market. What will we do? We push the bread and remove force. Therefore, we also observe their rheology. Do not forget, this is important, texture is a branch of a rheology. Some people, many people think that rheology and texture are different. No, rheology is comprising the texture. Texture is a branch of the rheology. Because if in textural measurements, for example, we want to determine the hardness of the bread, springiness of the bread, therefore we apply a force and we evaluate, we observe the response of the bread against applied force. Foods can be classified in different ways, such as solids, gels, homogeneous liquids, suspensions of solids in liquids, and emulsions. Foods that do not retain their shape but take the shape of their container are fluids, as known. Such materials may contain amounts of dissolved or suspended solids and exhibit non-Newtonian behavior, which classifies them as semi-fluids. Many of food materials exhibit both viscous and elastic properties. I want to show. Rheology is between purely liquids and purely solids. For example, purely water, oil, purely solid stone, and the generally the food materials viscoelastic character, show viscoelastic characteristics. What does it mean? They show also liquid character and also solid character. We use rheological parameters in product development, product specification, product optimization, structure function relation, polymer rheology, process development. We apply some forces during production process, for example piping the material. Therefore, all in all of these processes, in all of these steps, we need rheological parameters and product evaluation. It is also important in sensory properties of food materials. Liquids through products are formulated in such a manner to exhibit desirable flow property or viscosity. All of the food materials have different rheological character or flow behavior. For example, the expectations of consumers from honey is different from their expectations from ketchup, for example. Some foods are thick and creamy. For example, in yogurt or any drink, where some solid materials, fruit pieces are suspended, you want the suspended particles are homogenized in the yogurt or any drink. If the fluid parts rheology is not adjusted well, the solid particles are collected at the bottom of the fluid or material. Rheological properties are important to the design of flow processes, quality control, storage and processing stability measurements, predicting texture, learning about molecular and conformational change in food materials. The rheological characterization of foods provides important information for food scientists about ingredient selection strategies to design, improve and optimize their products, to select and optimize their manufacturing processes, and design packaging and storage strategies. And also plant design, quality control, evaluation of sensory properties. For example, we will mention it later. Incorrect layers and too much or too little chocolate on top of each surface. For example, you spread chocolate on the surface of waffle, biscuits, cake, and the amount of thickness of layers, chocolate layers, is correlated with the chocolate rheology. Feed forming at the bottom of the product is also related with the rheology. And we observe such kind of importance of rheology in many products. Rheology, many people know that rheology is equal to viscosity. It is not. Rheology is very broad area. Viscosity is one of the particles of rheology. What is viscosity? Viscosity means internal friction. between the molecules and particles present in the materials when gliding along each other in a flowing state or flow resistance. Which what parameters affect the viscosity? The most important parameter is size. Size of the material directly affects the internal friction of the material. And attraction of the molecular forces between the particles also affect the classify the materials, viscosity, liquids, and solids. And between them, between liquid and solid, there are many different behaviors. For example, viscoelastic liquids. What means viscoelastic liquid? These materials show both viscous and solid elastic character, but the fluid character is predominant. For example, coatings, paints, paper coatings, adhesives, emulsions, suspensions, dispersions. And we can also see gel-like materials. What does mean? As you know, gel is a material where solid is a continuous phase and liquid particles are a dispersed phases. Therefore, gel-like materials also have a viscoelastic character, but in this type of material, solid character is predominant. And depending on the their viscous and elastic characters, we are classifying the materials. Is there fluidity of a material? We use rotational tests. We measure viscosity, and if there viscoelastic characters, we can't use rotational test. We use in this case we use oscillation tests. There are some things on chat. Is there any question? I am controlling.
No, normally the participant will ask question in the end of your presentation.
Okay. And we see the viscosity of some products here. Water at temperature, as mentioned before, we said that viscosity is related with the attraction of the molecular bonds of the material. Therefore, temperature is one of the important parameters affecting the rheology viscosity of the materials. They change their viscosity changed depending of the temperature. How can we calculate the viscosity? Viscosity is equal to force, shear stress dividing by shear rate. Rheometers or viscosimeters measure the shear stress and shear rate values, and depending on these values, viscosity is calculated. What is shear stress and shear rate? Shear stress is applied force parallel to flow of the material. Shear rate is a relative deformation of the sample. Shear stress is effect, shear rate is response. Therefore, rheometer is applied shear stress to material and it measures the shear rate. How the material is deformed. Depending on shear stress and shear rate, the viscosity values are calculated. There are some shear rate values depending on the process. For example, we want to observe the sedimentation of the material. During this period, the shear rate values are very low values. If surface leveling is important for us, we can use the applied shear rate values 0.01 to 0.1. Extrusion process 10 to 1000. Pipe flow, pumping, filling into containers 10 to 10,000. Mixing, stirring 10 to 10,000. The application of the shear rates is important for us because the viscosity for many materials, viscosity changed with shear rate value for in non-Newtonian fluids. Therefore, which shear rate is important for us? Generally, in the papers, the shear rate values change between 0.1 to 100, but depending on the process, we must select the suitable shear rate values. Otherwise, the obtained value is nonsense. We cannot obtain anything from the results if we don't select the appropriate shear rate values. This is important. If the material is fitting to viscosity law, we classify them as a Newtonian fluids, such as water, oils, honey, viscoelastic liquids, shampoos, for example, viscoelastic solids, gels, rubbers, and ideally elastic solids, stone, steel. We classified them depending on the their solid character or liquid character. Most of the foods, materials, for example, ketchup, mayonnaise, chocolate, melted chocolate, all of them are showing viscoelastic characters, confectionery products, jellies, toffees, chewing gum, and depending on the their predominant character, liquid or solid, we determine viscoelastic liquids or viscoelastic solids. I mentioned that the rheometer provides us shear rate and shear stress values. Depending on it, we are classified the materials shear thinning, Newtonian, and shear thickening. What does it mean? Newtonian material, as you see from the graph, the viscosity of the material does not change depending on the shear rate. But for shear thinning material, if the shear rate increases, the viscosity of the material decreases. Shear thinning viscosity, if shear rate increases, viscosity also increases. Firstly, if we observe the shear rate and shear stress data, we firstly determine that material is material shear thinning, Newtonian or shear thickening. These are different different graphs for Newtonian shear thinning or shear thickening materials. We also named the shear thinning materials pseudoplastic, shear thinning thickening materials, dilated materials. What happens? Yani why the material showed shear thinning behavior or shear thinning behavior? Firstly, at rest, as seen at left, the material have some bonds, but during the application of force to material, the bonds between the materials are damaged, and therefore the material's response resistance against the force decreased. For shear thickening, we applied force, and this force results in agglomeration of the particles. Therefore, the particles show a more resistance against the flow. Therefore, they show shear thickening behavior. For example, are you consuming yogurt in Indonesia?
Yes.
Yeah. When you mixing the yogurt, what you see? If we mix it, the consistency of the viscosity of the yogurt decreases. That means yogurt shows a shear thinning behavior. What happens when we applied shear? At rest, material are formed such way, but if we apply a shear, materials orientation of the particles are flowing to applied shear. For example, we can break up agglomerates. This also calls to shear thinning behavior. At microscopic level, such variations are observed in the materials. They result to such behavior. For example, this is one experiment result. During also rheological measurements, microscopic waves are also obtained. As you see, the material structure, microscopic structure, also changed when applied to shear stress or shear rate. And depending on the shear rate and shear stress values, there are different flow behavior. For example, Newtonian model, you see the equation of the Newtonian model. For example, Herschel-Buckley model, there is also different equation. In Herschel-Buckley model, there is yield stress value. What is yield stress value? Yield stress value is equal to, for example, when you put the ketchup on your potato chips, but if you if you want to push the ketchup, you must exceed some force value. Otherwise, ketchup did not flow. At that force value is equal to yield stress value. If you apply force lower than yield stress value, the ketchup does not flow. And I also want to mention different rheological applications. For example, time-dependent value. You want to observe the viscosity change of the material during storage, for example. You want to observe a sedimentation, crystallization process, such type of phenomenons result in change of the viscosity of material. Therefore, in this time, you can apply a time-dependent measurement. You select the one shear rate and you observe the viscosity change depending with respect to time. But do not forget, in this type of measurement, the shear rate is constant. But in flow behavior measurement, you change to shear rate. You can obtain a shear rate versus shear rate shear rate versus shear stress value or shear rate versus viscosity value. But in time dependent tests, you can obtain a time versus viscosity value. And for example, here in first sample, viscosity is constant with respect to time. In second sample, viscosity decreases with respect to time. And third sample, viscosity increases with respect to time. There is also temperature dependent behavior. In this test, our aim is to observe the viscosity change with respect to temperature. For example, I want to observe the crystallization temperature of cocoa butter. During this test, I also select a constant shear rate and I am increasing or decreasing the temperature, and at that time I am measuring the viscosity value with respect to temperature. And at that point, the the viscosity value depending on the temperature, I am determining the crystallization temperature of the cocoa butter, for example. Or starch gelatinization. As most of you, starch is gelatinizing if you apply a temperature heating process when the starch in water solution suspension, for example, and viscosity change depending of the temperature, and by using the viscosity curve, we are obtaining the different parameters important for starch. For example, pasting temperature, which temperature starch starts to gelatinization. We can determine this from temperature versus viscosity graphs. And you can also obtain the melting gels, gelatinization of gelatin, for example, like this type of. And there are also penetration test normally, penetration is performed by using a texture analyzer, but you can also make a penetration test with rheometer. Also, you can, rheomicroscopy, you can also observe the microstructural properties of the material under the force applied. Tribology is a novel rheological measurement. This is important for friction measurement of the material. This is very important test for mouth filling. For example, some people, especially older people, have a problem during swallowing of the materials. They can't, therefore, for such people, the materials have low friction is desired. And you can optimize such products by using tribology equipments, tribology media. As fluid materials or viscoelastic materials have a different flow properties, for example, honey has different flow behavior when comparing with water. Powder materials have also different flow behavior. For example, you can put the sugar and flour, all of them, both of them have different characteristics. Some powder materials not flow, some easy flow, some free flow. You can also determine the powder properties by using rheometer equipped with powder cell. And humidity option, as known, water content of the material is important parameter for rheology. Yani water content of the material directly affects the viscosity of the material. Therefore, during different humidity values, material behaves differently. Therefore, there is also a beneficial equipment for such measurements. There is also a humidity option for rheometer. And by this equipment, using this equipment, you can determine the viscosity of the materials at different relative humidity values. And I want to show a short video about the rheology. Bebelat ve bekerin bilgisayar gelişimini destekler. Bebelat.
French fries are delicious. French fries with ketchup are a little slice of heaven. The problem is, it's basically impossible to pour exactly the right amount. We're so used to pouring ketchup, we don't realize how weird its behavior is. Imagine a ketchup bottle filled with a straight-up solid like steel. No amount of shaking would ever get the steel out. Now imagine that same bottle full of a liquid like water. That would pour like a dream. Ketchup, though, can't seem to make up its mind. Is it a solid or a liquid? Answer is, it depends. The world's most common fluids, like water, oils, and alcohols, respond to force linearly. If you push on them twice as hard, they move twice as fast. Sir Isaac Newton of Apple fame first proposed this relationship, and so those fluids are called Newtonian fluids. Ketchup, though, is part of a merry band of linear rule breakers called non-Newtonian fluids. Mayonnaise, toothpaste, blood, paint, peanut butter, and lots of other fluids respond to force non-linearly. That is, their apparent thickness changes depending on how hard you push, or how long, or how fast. And ketchup is actually non-Newtonian in two different ways. Way number one, the harder you push, the thinner ketchup seems to get. Below a certain pushing force, ketchup basically behaves like a solid. But once you pass that breaking point, it switches gears and becomes 1,000 times thinner than it was before. Sound familiar, right? Way number two, if you push with a force below the threshold force, eventually the ketchup will start to flow. In this case, time, not force, is the key to releasing ketchup from its glassy prison. All right, so why does ketchup act all weird? Well, it's made from tomatoes, pulverized, smashed, thrashed, utterly destroyed tomatoes. See these tiny particles? This is what remains of tomato cells after they go through the ketchup treatment. And the liquid around those particles, that's mostly water and some vinegar, sugar, and spices. When ketchup is just sitting around, the tomato particles are evenly and randomly distributed. Now, let's say you apply a weak force very quickly. The particles bump into each other, but can't get out of each other's way, so the ketchup doesn't flow. Now, let's say you apply a strong force very quickly. That extra force is enough to squish the tomato particles. So maybe instead of little spheres, they get smushed into little ellipses. And boom, now you have enough space for one group of particles to get past others, and the ketchup flows. Now, let's say you apply a very weak force, but for a very long time. Turns out, we're not exactly sure what happens in this scenario. One possibility is that the tomato particles near the walls of the container slowly get bumped towards the middle, leaving the soup they were dissolved in, which remember is basically water, near the edges. That water serves as a lubricant between the glass bottle and the center plug of ketchup, and so the ketchup flows. Another possibility is that the particles slowly rearrange themselves into lots of small groups, which then flow past each other. Scientists who study fluid flows are still actively researching how ketchup and its merry friends work. Ketchup basically gets thinner the harder you push, but other substances like oobleck or some natural peanut butters actually get thicker the harder you push. Others can climb up rotating rods or continue to pour themselves out of a beaker once you get them started. From a physics perspective, though, ketchup is one of the more complicated mixtures out there. And as if that weren't enough, the balance of ingredients and the presence of natural thickeners like xanthan gum, which is also found in many fruit drinks and milkshakes, can mean that two different ketchups behave completely differently. But most will show two telltale properties: sudden thinning at a threshold force and more gradual thinning after a small force is applied for a long time. And that means you could get ketchup out of the bottle in two ways. Either give it a series of long, slow, languid shakes, making sure you don't ever stop applying force, or you could hit the bottle once very, very hard. What the real pros do is keep the lid on, give the bottle a few short, sharp shakes to wake up all those tomato particles, and then take the lid off and do a nice controlled pour onto their heavenly fries.
Dear professor, how many minutes I have?
You still have 10 minutes left, and then afterwards we will continue with a Q&A session.
10 minutes?
Yes, 10 to 15 minutes.
Oh, it is very short and...
But you can also continue, and then we will have we can have a short Q&A session then. That will be okay also.
I have a...
or for you, I mean for the student and the participants, if you have any question, you can drop your question now so that Prof. Toker can answer directly. I think that's a good idea rather than we wait until your presentation finish.
No problem, yeah. Share my screen, why?
Yeah, that's too big, I guess.
This is a very wide area, therefore I want to make a summary as I made is it possible?
Yeah, that's possible.
And now I want to pass the chocolate geology, importance of the geology, our main subject.
Okay. Prof, we have around 1 hour left, so you can continue to discuss this, I think around 30 to 40 minutes, and then we will have discussion around 20 minutes then. Yeah, that's perfect.
See presentation.
We can see your presentation, actually.
You can see?
I can see, yes, I can see.
Okay, nice.
But now it's not anymore. So maybe you can share it again, because a moment ago we can see it. I will let you know. Yeah, we can see your presentation, Prof.
Sorry for the problem. And chocolate geology. Geology is also very important for chocolate. For example, holes in the surface of tablets like this. Air bubbles stuck in the chocolate like this. And leveling problem on the surface of the material like this, all of them are related with collagen. Correct layers and too much or too little chocolate on top of particles surface feed forming is also related with chocolate. As you see from two pictures, there is not a good leveling of the chocolate on the surface. This is absolutely related with wrong chocolate rheology. By this way, the thickness of the chocolate coating is very high. This is not economic for chocolate producers, chocolate industry, and this is not good for consumer. Feed forming. See here, at the bottom, there are feed forming. This is also related with rheology. Chocolate shows non-Newtonian character. What does it mean? It is viscosity changed with the applied shear rate. For example, you see in this graph, viscosity of the chocolate changed with the shear rate. I mentioned that shear rate affects the viscosity. Therefore, in different production steps of the chocolate, we need viscosity value at different shear rates. For example, if we want to observe the viscosity of the chocolate during molding process, we must select the low shear rate values. If we want to observe the viscosity rheology or viscosity value during spraying process, we must select the high shear rate values. This is important for optimizing the process. For example, we have such problem like this. We must select the low shear rate values. If we must select for we must observe the viscosity of the chocolate for spinning process, we must select the higher shear rate values. How can we measure the viscosity of the rheology of the chocolate? We can observe viscosity at one shear rate value. Viscosity measurements at different shear rate values of flow curve measurements. For example, during enrobing process, we must select the shear rate value at 25. During pumping, viscosity is important for us. Shear rate 7.5 is okay for us. And molding viscosity, lower shear rate values we need. melted chocolate shows Kasson behavior. And you see the equation of the Kasson behavior. We obtained Kasson yield value, the force required to start flow in chocolate, like ketchup. And Kasson plastic viscosity, yeah, the force required to maintain a constant flow in chocolate at any shear rate. This is typical viscosity curve, flow curve for chocolate value. As you see, the viscosity decreases with increasing shear rate. For example, why the selecting appropriate shear rate value is important. You see, there are blue and red colors graph. This is for different chocolate samples. For example, at that shear rate value, the viscosity of both chocolates is equal. If you select this point, there is no difference between chocolates. If you optimize the process at depending on the this shear rate value, there might be a problem. But you see, at higher shear rate values, for important for enrobing process, there are big difference between the their viscosity. Therefore, selecting the optimum shear rate is very important for us. What affects the chocolate rheology formulation and process? If we think the process of the chocolate, what are we doing? Mixing, refining process, as I mentioned in previously, what I said, molecular size affected the rheology. Therefore, refining process, particle size of the chocolate changed in this process. Refining process affects the rheology. And then conching process. What are we doing in conching process? There is a removal of water from the chocolate. Water content affects the viscosity. Therefore, conching process affects the viscosity. And there is also some particle size decreases during conching process. It also affects the chocolate rheology. And the most important step affecting chocolate rheology is tampering process. Because in this process, the chocolate cocoa butter polymorphs changed. By this change, the viscosity of the chocolate is also changed. During tampering, if you make a tampering, if the time passes during tampering, you see the viscosity of the chocolate increases. Some people determine the complete period of when tampering process is finished, they determine it observing the viscosity value. And formulation, amount of sugar, amount of milk-based ingredients, amount of cocoa butter or other butter, emulsifier, milk powder, milk proteins, or also directly affected the rheology of chocolate. But for optimizing the rheology of chocolate, emulsifiers are widely used in the industry. Which emulsifiers are used? Lecithin, ammonium phosphatate, and PGPR as a co-emulsifier are used in the chocolate industry. Lecithin is oldest and most well-known chocolate emulsifier. In US, it is permitted up to 1% lecithin. And how lecithin affected the rheology? As you see in the graph and in the table, it decreases the yield value, but after using higher concentration of emulsifier than 0.4, yield value is increased again. Generally, lecithin is used for plastic viscosity, but if yield value increases, there is problem for chocolate production. For example, leveling of the surface. Therefore, we need a secondary emulsifier PGPR used for decreasing the yield value of the chocolate. For example, there is two different chocolate. One of them including 0.8 lecithin. You see, it is yield value is very high. Therefore, there is a problem of leveling of the chocolate. But if you use 0.4 lecithin, it spreads the on the surface easily. This is very important. Ammonium phosphate is another emulsifier used. It has also plastic lowering effect, but yield value like lecithin. This is advantage of the ammonium phosphate.
Hello, Lucky.
And PGPR. PGPR is used for lowering the yield stress value of the chocolate. It is generally used with lecithin because lecithin decreases the plastic value and PGPR decreases the yield value. Therefore, combination of them uses in the chocolate formulations. Okay, this is end of my presentation. Thanks for attending. Thanks for listening. If there is a question, I can try to answer them.
Okay, thank you, Prof. Tokker. This is very interesting topic. Looks so complicated, but this is very interesting. But yeah, before we start with the Q&A session, I would like to summarize some important points from the presentation, from your presentation as follow. The first one is that there are a lot of things in food production which need the rheology knowledge, such as formulation, composition, additive stabilizers, production, storage, and yeah, applications. Second one is that liquid and liquid-like materials can be classified into two types, namely Newtonian and non-Newtonian. The third is that rheological properties can be modeled using several models such as a Herschel-Balkley model, power law, Bingham, Kaizen models, and many more. And yeah, chocolate rheology is influenced by mainly two factors, namely processing methods and formulation. Now we will continue with the discussion session. I will start with a question from the chat box. As we can see here that actually there are some questions, one sent to everyone, and I also have some sent privately to me. And for you, for students and also participants, if you have question, please do not hesitate to raise your hand, or you can also write your question in the chat box, please. Okay, this is the first question, Prof. Tokker. I will just write it as I see here. Thanks, Pak Omer Said, for the explanation. This looks a complex process, but in terms of taste, is there any changes that affected by those process? At the end, taste will impact to the product perception by consumer, by customer.
Yeah, as I understand from the question, is there relation between rheology and test?
Yes.
Perception, yeah. This is a good question. thanks to Muhammad Hilal for this nice question. Yes, there is a correlation, deep correlation between rheology and test perception of the chocolate. As I mentioned in tribology, if the friction is very low, what that is mean? The sample goes to very fastly in your mouth. Therefore, you cannot easily percept the test because it is not waiting in your mouth at required time. But if the friction is low, the sample is waiting more time in your mouth and you can feel the test very much. And viscosity is also directly affects the flavor perception of the chocolate. If the viscosity is low, you can easily feel the flavor compounds. If the matrix is viscous, you can it can be problem for feeling the flavor compounds, because the what is the taste feeling when the receptor in your mouth and the flavor compound will come together, you can feel the taste. Therefore, the viscosity of the food matrix directly affect the combination of receptor and flavor compound. Therefore, it also affects the feeling of test.
Okay, that's clear, Muhammad Hilal. Okay, I think that's good enough for you.
Thank you.
Okay, Prof. Toker, there is another question sent privately to me. And the question is, what is the difference among rheological models that you mentioned, such as Herschel-Walkley, Power Law, Bingham, and Cousins? Could you please explain this?
I can't understand.
Okay, what is the difference among or between rheological models that you mentioned in your presentation? What is the difference between Herschel-Walkley, Power Law, Bingham, and
anymore? It's also a good question. I qualify by therefore due to the time restrictions, I did not show it.
Could you please the committee to mute? Okay.
Yeah, for example, this is general equation for models. For example, in Herschel-Walkley model, as I said, there is a yield stress value. I want to get a yield stress value. See, the graph starts with 100 value. This is yield stress value. If there is not a yield stress value, it starts from zero value. This is if n value shows the shear flow behavior index. It shows the thinning or thickening behavior or Newtonian behavior of the sample. If it is equal to 1, you see the constant relation between shear rate and shear stress. The axis shows the shear rate value. Y axis shows the shear stress value. This is typical behavior of the Newtonian material. If I want to yield stress value. This is for this type of behavior Bingham plastic value, because there is a stress. If I select the n value lower than 1, or change to Herschel-Buckley model. Therefore, their relation between shear rate and shear stress change depending of the model. What to for determining the best model? Firstly, we are looking to shear rate and shear stress curve. Is it shear thinning or shear thickening? Firstly, we are determining it. And then, we are looking, is there any yield stress value or not? If it is yield stress value, we can determine it is Herschel-Buckley model or it has different models. We must experience with shear rate and shear stress values for determining which model is appropriate for our product.
Okay, yeah, that's enough. I hope that the question is clear enough for you, Bu Evi, who asked the question. We can have more discussion later about that. And Prof. Toker, I have one student who would like to ask a question directly because she raised her hand already. For Amanda Givari, please, you can ask directly to Prof. Toker.
All right. Thank you for the chance of asking.
I'm sorry. Could you please open your camera?
All right.
On your camera, yeah, so that we can recognize you.
I'm sorry that I currently don't have the background, and I would like to ask directly about the topic. So, excuse me, can I turn off the camera first?
Okay.
I would like to ask about, since this is also about designing the products of the chocolate, I see that there are several factors that affecting the chocolate properties, rheological properties. So while designing the chocolate specific to the products desired product, is there any steps or like order in which these parts?
Amanda, could you please repeat your question, because I don't know, but my connection here is not really clear, so that I cannot really, really hear your voice.
I'm sorry that I repeat again.
Yeah.
So, Professor, I would like to ask that, is there any order or priority on which the factors can be given in like the pre-deciding and the pre-finalization of the chocolate? For example, that I would like to make a chocolate bar, and then do we can I design first the forces applied to match the shear rate needed, or can I first add the emulsifiers and additions that in order to make more effective testing in which the materials are given. Thank you so much. I hope the question is clear.
Sorry, I can't understand well the question. What about Professor Sapotra? If you understand, yeah. You can explain.
Yeah. Yeah, Professor Toker, I think you want to know about what is the kind of the most important factors that we need to consider first before we do like a rheology measurement. So let's say if we want to I have one chocolate, mm-hmm. And then which one that we need to consider? The setting, I mean the shear rate, the shear strength that we need to apply, or yeah, about the formulation. Okay, the formulation,
The most important factor, the adjusting the temperature. Because temperature is very critical for chocolate rheology. Therefore, the constant temperature is very important. The temperature does not change during the measurement. Generally, the viscosity of the chocolate is determined at 40 Celsius degree. And in the industry, generally, the emulsifier type and concentration change for optimizing the chocolate rheology. I don't know if it is adequate for her question or not.
Yeah, I think that's enough, professors. I think that's enough. Is it okay, Amanda, about the answers?
Yes, it is clear. Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Amanda, for the nice question also. We still have two questions, Prof. Toker. I think we can go with that. The first one is, this question is actually from our head of department, Prof. Lili Sutiarso. Mm-hmm. She is not working on chocolate, but I do understand that he loves especially dark chocolate. And his question is, yeah, thanks for the presentation. Among those rheology parameters, which ones are the most important parameters for producing nice taste or the most preferred chocolate products?
Thanks for the question. This is a very difficult question. Because in rheological measurements, we obtain a relative results. For example, we cannot say if this chocolate viscosity has 5 between 10, this test is very beautiful. We cannot say this because there are many different parameters affecting the test of the chocolate. But viscosity, matrix viscosity, yani for example, chocolate's viscosity or chocolate's yield stress directly affect the flavor sensation of the chocolate because it affects the connection between flavor compound and receptor in our mouth. What we do for this? We select the best chocolate in terms of its sensorial properties, and we measure its rheology, and we can say yes, if the viscosity of the chocolate between this value, this is good for in terms of sensory parameters. In recent years, tribology results and sensory results are correlated well. There is also study for chocolate tribology and sensory properties of chocolate for determination of relation between tribology and sensory properties of chocolate. In this paper, they said, yes, friction behavior of the chocolate is important for sensory properties of chocolate. Viscosity is related with test of the chocolate. Tribological parameters is also correlated with sensory of properties of chocolate, and yield stress value is also related with chocolate sensory properties.
Sorry, still mute. Prof. Lily, is it clear? Okay, thanks. Yeah. Yeah, there is actually two more questions. I will, yeah, please, you can answer this also in quick way. For making chocolate, we need an emulsifier. Yes, for sure. Which emulsifiers is the best one? PGPR or lecithin?
It's emulsifiers determine the machine ability of the chocolate products. For example, the aim of the your aim is important. You use chocolate as a coating material, or you use chocolate directly for molding. That is important. Yeah. Why you use chocolate? Firstly, you mentioned this. Depending on it, we cannot say which one is better. But if you use lecithin and you need low yield stress value, you must use lecithin and PGPR combination. But AMP is advantage. Has advantage when compared with lecithin, because it does not cause the increased yield stress value. But maybe in your process, in your usage aim, yield stress value must be high. Therefore, you use only lecithin is okay, is best for you. But you need low plastic viscosity value and low yield stress value. In this time, you need combine lecithin and PGPR, or you must use AMP only. This depends on, not anyone says that for chocolate, lecithin is the best emulsifier. This is absolutely related with your usage aim of the chocolate.
And how about like a natural and synthetic issue? Do you think is it okay?
Lecithin is produced from soy. Therefore, yeah. there can issue about the genetically modified soy. GMP okay. Can be, yeah, genetical modification can be problem if you use soy lecithin, but it can be also produced from sunflower. Mm-hmm. It is preferred more than soy lecithin.
More than soy lecithin. Okay, this is last question, Prof. Toker. How to measure the flow properties of chocolate? How to measure flow properties of chocolate? Maybe just the practical way. Yeah.
Yes, we measure rheological properties of chocolate by using viscosimeter or rheometer, and we measure the flow properties of the chocolate at shear rate range of 0.1 to 50. That means we change the shear rate values 0.5 to 50 shear rate values, and we observe the viscosity of the chocolate in this range. And depending on the our aim, if we want to observe the yield stress value, we calculate the yield stress value from model, and we compare the yield stress value of the chocolates, for example. Of you want to select the specific shear rate for comparison, for example, molding process, and you want to compare the viscosity of chocolate at 5 shear rate value. You can select the viscosity of chocolate at 5 shear rate value, and you can obtain the data. Or if you want to only observe the viscosity of the chocolate at 5 shear rate value, you can adjust the viscosimeter or rheometer at constant shear rate value of 5, and you can observe the viscosity of the chocolate at that single shear rate value. There are different approaches for measurement of the chocolate rheology, but the most important factor is temperature. If you measure the chocolate rheology before hours, the measurement maybe 1 or 2 hours, you must store it oven at 30-40 Celsius degree, and you must adjust the rheometer temperature at that temperature at 30 Celsius degree, and you must also, if you use viscosimeter, you must also adjust your water bed at that temperature, and you can start your measurement.
Okay, thank you. I hope that's clear enough for Pak Joko Nugroho, who asked this question. Okay, thank you, Prof. Toker. We learned a lot about rheology in food sectors. Yeah, your talk really helped us to have a better understanding about this topic, particularly for chocolate rheology. Yeah, since some of my students have to deal with this in their research. So your explanation will show them the basic theory of rheology measurement. For chocolate maker, I can see that some of them also join this session. I'm sure that they now start considering their processing method and formulation to achieve the characteristic of chocolate that they need. And before we end this talk, we have a certificate as a token of gratitude, which will be sent to your email address also. Could you please, committee, to show the certificate?
Thank you very much.
Okay. Yeah. So yeah, this is the certificate will be sent in PDF files to you.
Thank you very much. Yeah.
Or if you have something to say.
I want to also thank to you, dear Professor Saputro, and organizing committee of this event. I said before, I am very happy to be here, and I share my contact information, my phone number, my email number. Whenever you want or participants want, they can contact with me. And I also want to thank to all participants for their patience, their listening. I hope this presentation is beneficial for you. Thank you everything.
Okay, yeah, thank you, Prof. Once again, on behalf of the Department of Agricultural and Biosystem Engineering, I would like to thank for your time and have a good day. Bye. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you to Mr. Arifin Dwi Saputro who has led the discussion this afternoon. Once again, thank you to Prof. Dr. Omid Said Toker who have presented the amazing lesson.
You are welcome.
Okay, so before we closing this event, we ask for a moment to for a photo session. So for all participants, please to kindly activate the video. Ya, sebelum kita menutup acara pada sore hari ini, kami meminta waktunya sesi foto bersama ya, karena itu dimohon untuk seluruh peserta untuk mengaktifkan videonya.
Okay. Siapa yang ambil fotonya, Mas?
Saya, Pak.
Oke, okay. Dihitung ya.
Oke. Okay. Okay. Di sini ada 5 slide. We have 5 slides here, so please to hold your smile because you don't know where is your slide gitu. Oke. Oke. 1, 2, 3. Oke, slide 2. 1, 2, 3. Oke, okay, slide 3. 1, 2, 3. Slide 4. 1, 2, 3. Slide 5. 1, 2, 3. Oke, okay, thank you for activate your video. Thanks again to all participants who have attended this guest lecture until the end of this event. It is reminded again for all participants to fill your attendance that has been shared in the chat room, because we only distribute certificates to participants who have filled out the attendance list. Further information can be accessed on our social media. On behalf of Committee on Duty, I apologize if there are many wrong words and action in this event. Thanks again for your attention and participation in today's event. And don't forget to follow our social media account to see more upcoming events. Instagram at tpb.ugm, Facebook, Twitter at tpbugm. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Bye everybody.
Thank you.